Oscar Wilde's literature were based on the movements of aestheticism and decadentism. He also wrote comedies, gothic literature, and poetry, with the idea of making you feel delighted and relieved. He also affirmed that the purpose of literature was the beauty. He distinguished himself by possessing a abiding and critical sense of humor that liked to expose the excesses of Victorian society. Maybe this made them feel furious and bitter. He wrote short stories and novels, and among his most recognized titles are The Happy Prince, The Picture of Dorian Gray, and The Importance of Being Earnest, which gave him the golden opportunity to be a famous writer.
Samuel Langhorne Clemens, recognized by his pen name Mark Twain, was an American speaker, comedian, and writer born in 1835 in Florida, who wrote many works that achieved great success and world fame, such as The Prince and the Pauper or A Connecticut Yankee in King Arthur's Court, though his best-known novel is The Adventures of Tom Sawyer. His distinctive style of writing often delves into satire and social morality, that also incline into fictional and traveling narratives.
He was born in Portland, USA in 1947. American writer, he won critical acclaim with his first novel, Carrie, which was followed by The Shining, which earned him great international prestige, It, Misery, and Insomnia, to mention just a few of his greatest successes. His effective and direct style, together with his great ability to highlight the most disturbing aspect of everyday life, have made him the best-selling horror literature specialist in history. He is also the author of short story and television scripts, and many of these novels have been made into films.
The story begins in a dystopian America, where a great event called the Long Walk takes place, in which 100 adolescent boys who walk without rest, called the Walkers, must spend time in an extensive journey with a continuous pace of 4 miles per hour. If they do not comply with the last requirement, they will receive 3 warnings, and if it happens one more time, they will be shot by a group of soldiers who supervise them during the event. The last participant will receive a large sum of money and a prize of their choice. Our protagonist is Ray Garrity, who arrives at the start of the walk on the Canada Maine border, meeting other walkers such as the sardonic McVries, the friendly Baker, the cocky Olson, and the intriguing Stebbins. The Major, who's the leader of the secret force known as the Squads, starts the event. In the first day, Garrity befriends Baker, Olson, Abraham, and Pearson, growing closer to McVries and becoming intrigued by Stebbins. A walker named Barkovich tells a reporter that he's in the Long Walk to dance on the grave of other participants, and later provokes another walker to attack him, resulting in the walker's death and Barkovich being excluded. Garrity survives the night. Scram, the favorite in Vegas, tells Garrity that he has a pregnant wife and that's his motivation to keep going. Garrity decides that his motivation will be surviving until Freeport, which will allow him to see his girlfriend Jan in the crowd. The walkers begin to resent the Major, and McVries stops walking in an attempt to fight the soldiers, but is saved by Garrity. In return, McVries saves Garrity's life after Garrity experiences hysterics when there's more spectators. This closeness makes Olson mad, who is very tired and wants Garrity to die. Garrity reveals to the others that his father was squatted, and a fight almost breaks between McVries and another walker, Coley Parker, when Parker claims that only damn fools are squatted.
Stebbins tells Garrity that he believes he will win, and that the walkers are participating because they want to die. McBride and Baker seem to be examples of this, because McBride was looking for pain and Baker's fascination with death. Scram contracts pneumonia and he is unable to finish the walk, and the other walkers agree that the winner should provide financial security for Scram's wife. After, Scram thanks the others and dies in a night of defense against the soldiers. After, Garty receives three warnings and has to walk for an hour to lose one. To distract himself, he tells Mac Bryce how he felt the compulsion to join the walk and that his mother has blinded by the idea of financial security. Mac Bryce reveals that he joined the walk against his family's wishes, and Abraham tells Garty that he didn't withdraw after being accepted because of the fun he provided for his people.
Garty begins to suffer from doubts about his sexuality and masculinity, especially after Mac Bryce hints that he is sexually attracted to Garty. This causes Garty to lash out at a deteriorating Barkovich, and Barkovich commits suicide when the rest of the walkers begin taunting him. When the walkers arrive in Freeport, Garty attempts to go to Jan's arms with the intention to die, but is saved by Mac Bryce. As a response, Abraham convinces the walkers to make a promise to stop helping each other. Later, Park starts a revolution against the soldiers, but is killed when nobody joins in. Abraham catches pneumonia. Baker falls over and gains a severed nosebleed.
Due to the promise, nobody can help him up.
On the morning of the fifth day, Stebbins reveals that he is the major's son and that his prize will be accepted into the major's household. However, the major is using him as a rabbit to cause the walk last longer, which has worked. Baker, described as a roadblock machine, tells Garty that he can't walk any further, and thanks Garty for being his friend. With Baker dead, the only remaining walkers are Garty, Stamis, and Mac Bryce. Nevertheless, Mac Bryce begins walking at the crow, and Garty breaks his promise and saves him. However, Mac Bryce chooses to sit down and die peacefully. A miserable Garty decides that he will give up, because Stebbins cannot be beaten. When he tries to tell Stebbins, Stebbins clutches at him in horror and falls over dead. His corpse is shot when the major arrives. This leaves Garty as the uncomprehending winner. He feels disoriented and ignores the major and approaches the dark figure, who he believes to be another walker, declaring that there is
still so far to walk.